precinct.
Yes, it's me, your favourite crime-solving devil.
When I first got the pilot script for Lucifer, by about the third page, I was like, oh my God, this character is brilliant, and I have to play him.
I was like, wait, they took Lucifer and made him a crime-solving devil in Los Angeles?
Who doesn't want to write for a character that can pretty much say or do whatever he wants?
Lucifer Morningstar. Is that like a stage name or something?
God-given, I'm afraid.
I've done a lot of incredible things on the show with incredible actors.
I'll just never forget, like, laughing that hard while you're trying to shoot.
It's not often in life that you get to experience what we've experienced on this show.
I immediately get choked up because I would say that I'm so grateful.
And this has just been one of the most fulfilling experiences of my career.
So, Lucifer, I'm ready to get started crying. Episode 610, Partners Till the End. Act 1, interior Lucifer's penthouse night. Lucifer slowly sets down the phone. He looks to Chloe, who is reeling.
How is this possible?
How can Lamech have Rory? You said Dan was in his body.
Apparently not anymore. How did he even get his hands on her? She's an angel.
Here we are, going out the way that we want after 6 seasons. That's pretty spectacular.
I've loved every minute of it. Tell me, what is it you truly desire?
What is it you truly desire?
What is your... Oh my God, what is it?
Tell me, what is it you truly desire?
What is it you truly desire?
But you have to hold the blink for really long.
No, my impression of Tom is awful. It's awful.
What is it you truly desire? Oh, that's terrible.
Haven't blinked.
I totally remember my first day on set. It was the day Chloe had to go to Trixie's school to pick her up because she was in a fight.
And I'm so nervous about this weirdo guy that I've just met, and I tell him to stay in the car.
I go and talk to Scarlett, and she asked me what my name is.
What's your name?
Lucifer.
Like the devil.
She goes, like the devil, with no teeth.
On the first day that we shot, they didn't really know my background, so I was a little bit nervous. And the best thing that happened was when I made them break. They started laughing in the middle of the scene, and they kind of both went, oh, you're funny.
My favorite scenes are probably all of the musical ones, but in particular, it was the first time we really went full bananas, where Tom sang Luck Be a Lady and Ella was a showgirl.
One day I'll be coming in and doing something completely ridiculous and so silly. And then the next day there'll be a very, very emotional, heartfelt scene. And then the next day I'll be singing a song. And the day after that I'll be doing a fight.
I always call the show like a weird stew. It can always surprise you.
I know that I'm going to get to do the most fun, random things like play poker or sing, dance.
We have great writers. We have great actors. Our crew is incredible. Netflix has been fantastic. But the thing that sticks with me the most is our fans.
I will never get tired of that.
Our fan base is incredible. They've been so fiercely loyal.
It's so beautiful to see strangers from all over the world come together and have a common ground from one story and then become friends without even ever having met each other.
This isn't a normal experience, and I think you know that, fans, and we know that as well. And what happened with this show, the kind of like the second coming of this show on Netflix, happened because of the fans.
They rallied when, quite honestly, we thought the show was over. We all started to move on, and they did not let go.
There were some sites that popped up, like Save Lucifer Italy, Save Lucifer Brazil. It was from every country you could imagine.
We were done, and they were just these little angels from all over the world, and they created this Lucifer family.
You are why we have season 4, season 5, and season 6.
Because of them, we got to end it on our terms, which is an incredible thing and very rare nowadays.
It changed everything for us, and we've been able to complete our story, and it's been brilliant.
I didn't really understand the power that fans have when they like a show, and I do now. And I don't take that for granted, and I think we were very lucky, and I can't say thank you enough.
Thank you for being in our corner, and thank you for wanting to see us tell this story.
thank you for your dedication, your time, your thoughtful letters, kind words. Thank you for being so loyal and so passionate and so relentless in fighting for us.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Next to you is an iPad. The fans have sent in a video to let you guys know how special it's been. So I just wanted you to watch it.
Now you are going to make me cry.
Tom and Lauren's chemistry on screen together is electrifying. It's magnetic. It is just everything.
1 second it's a funny joke. Second, it's an emotional, touching moment.
I'd like to thank the producers, the writers, the cast, the crew, Netflix, and my fellow Lucy fans for making such a beautiful difference in my life and for helping to create this wonderful, inclusive fandom.
Thank you guys for bringing this show to life and so much happiness for all of us.
Oh man.
You are the best and I love you all.
Thank you, cast, crew, writers, everyone involved in making the show what it is and involving the fans in the way that you have and making us feel like we're a part of the family.
Lucifer is just a show that everybody should be watching because there is literally nothing like it on TV.
I agree.
It's a show that we can enjoy as a family. And we can watch it repeatedly. We've watched it so many times. And it has such a positive message for everyone to learn. Thank you very much for everything you've done.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for the joy, the fear, the tears. I love you. Je vous aime.
Oh my God. So sweet.
Amazing.
That was beautiful.
Ah.
You made a demon cry.
Thank you.
Sort of says it all, really, doesn't it?
We're at the end of the show. We're all very emotional. The cast, the crew, and the writers.
Whew. A lot of the joy that I derive from the job comes from the people we work with. Our crew's like family.
That final table read was just very emotional. I can't believe it's the last one.
The door closes gently in our faces. And we end our series.
Woo-hoo! What we created was just magical, on and off screen. And yeah, well done, everyone. You should give yourselves a massive pat on the back because it doesn't happen very often.
It's been a once-in-a-lifetime experience. This show will always be a part of my heart.
It's amazing when you put so much of your heart into something and you feel like it actually reaches people, it actually touches people.
How people felt a sense of hope and redemption.
It makes everything I do and everything I ever want to do in this life worth it. So thank you guys.
And that's what really makes me smile when you find out that you're working on something that for whatever reason made someone feel good.
I was able to change, to grow. To find true meaning in life. It has been a truly unique experience, this, and we just wanted to entertain people. But the heart and the soul that people have found in this show is something that we've all put into it, and I'm so glad that people have found that. So, thank you.
Because if the devil can be redeemed, then anyone can.